Spanish nationality by residence. Now, let's start with the basics. If you're dreaming of becoming a Spanish citizen through residency, you'll need to meet some specific requirements. It's not just about living in Spain. It's about the type of residence you hold and how long you've been here. Let's break it down. General rule. The standard requirement is a continuous 10 years of residence in Spain before you can apply for Spanish nationality. For refugees, if you are recognized as one, it only takes 5 years of residence to be eligible. Then there are special cases. For folks from Ibero-American countries, Andorra, the Philippines, Equatorial Guinea, Portugal, or Sephardic Jews, you can apply after just 2 years of residence. And under special circumstances, there are also some unique situations where just 1 year of residence is enough. This includes being born on Spanish territory, not exercising the right to choose, being under the guardianship of a Spanish citizen or institution for 2 consecutive years, being married to a Spanish citizen for 1 year, being a widow or widower of a Spanish citizen, or having Spanish ancestry. Now that you know the time limits, let's talk about the type of residence that counts. Not all permits or cards will help you on your journey to Spanish citizenship. For instance, having a non-lucrative residence permit can be your golden ticket to meeting the time requirements. But if you're holding a student card, sorry to burst your bubble, it won't count towards your Spanish nationality application. Well, let's clarify this once and for all. First, the Civil Code makes it crystal clear that you must have legal residency in Spain to even think about applying for Spanish nationality. Second, according to immigration laws, there's a clear distinction between a study stay and residency, estancia versus residencia. They are not one and the same. So your student card is a sign of your stay in Spain, not your residency, and it won't help you on your journey to Spanish nationality. Now, I should mention that in the past, the Ministry of Justice used to consider some time spent on a study stay when assessing applications, but as of today, in 2023, that's no longer the case. Student card and long-term EU residence permit. But don't lose hope if you are a student here in Spain. While it may not help you become a Spanish citizen, your time spent as a student does count towards obtaining the long-term EU residence card. According to Article 152 of Royal Decree 557 of 2011, as of August 24 of 2023, foreigners can qualify for a long-term EU residence permit by meeting certain criteria, including 5 years of legal and continuous residence in Spain. Importantly for this permit, time spent as a student is considered, albeit at 50% of its duration, provided you are in resident status in Spain at the time of the application. This means students can eventually secure a long-term EU residence card while studying in Spain, making it easier for them to stay in this beautiful country. In conclusion, there you have it, folks, the lowdown on residence requirement for Spanish nationality. It's all about the right type of residence and meeting those time limits. Remember, the journey to becoming a Spanish citizen can be quite the adventure, but with the right information, you are well on your way. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to Spenguru for more valuable insights into life and legal matters in Spain. If you are interested in exploring which kind of visa or residence permits could suit you best, we have prepared a 50-page PDF guide that explains you every single visa and residence permit in Spain and your way into permanent residence or long-term residence and even Spanish nationality. I'll be sharing the link here in the video description and in this video as well, so you can download it. It is completely free and it will give you a panoramic view of all the different possibilities that you may have in order to come to live in Spain. Thank you.